calls that is the hardest to make for officials is when both players are battling for the basketball. Who has the ball out of bounds? You know, who last touched it? That can be a very tough call to make for the officials.
Well, and those can occur out of the correct positioning of the referee. And, you know, they're always put where they can see the most. But some of those deflections out of bounds can be anywhere, and they don't get a good angle on it.
1-1 situation. Christine Mussel on the free throw line for the Chargers, getting the shot to go. The last foul for Midland was on Lily Hami, who now has three fouls. So three different Kimmick players with three fouls each. Second half of the 1-1 is no good, but how about that? A steal coming up. Heather Durstein getting the steal for the Chargers. 11-point Dow lead with just under 4 minutes to play in this contest.
It's amazing how effective a deflected pass can be in a ball game like this.
Christine Mussel working over to Kaylee Wettkamp. Wettkamp losing the dribble. Midland High will have the basketball.
That was real good defense by Jessica Walter. Disrupted Wettkamp's dribble and then went off her foot.
Walter with the basketball for Midland. Getting the ball back. Walter driving baseline, fires the shot up, the bucket and the foul. Walter with a chance for a 3-point play. Walter with a nice drive. She is just a junior, is Jessica Walter.
And she's also a Hoosier. She's heading to the University of Indiana after next year.
And Walter completes the 3-point play for Midland High. 3.5 minutes to play, 54-46. Dow High with the basketball.
Walter has 18 tonight.
And almost came up with a steal. Josie Query working the ball back to Christine Mussel. Mussel over to Kaylee Wettkamp. Wettkamp taking a couple of dribbles. Crosses back at the top of the key. Now back out to Christine Mussel. The Chargers very happy to run time off the clock. Under 3 minutes to play in the game. Query taking the block. Drives into the elbow. Query can't get the shot to go. Rebound by Lily Hami. And we're going to have a reach-in foul called against Mussel. The Chargers are trying to double team, but Mussel making a little bit too much contact.
Well, they either call the foul or they call traveling on Hami, and they can't call the traveling. Too much contact.
Lily Hami bringing the ball across for the Kimmicks. Now to Walter. Walter driving the baseline. She's being double teamed. That leaves somebody wide open, but the shot does not go for Alyssa Westfall. Now the ball on the ground. Emily Holman had it briefly, and a jump ball is going to be called. Possession arrow belonging to the Chargers.
Looks like Jessica Walters having to work out a cramp in her leg. She's been working on her toes and her calf a little bit.
Ribs, calf.
Boy, but she's got 18 tonight. She's a warrior.
Inside, no good for Heather Durstein. Midland will come back the other way. Numbers advantage. Walter will take it herself. Count the bucket. Jessica Walter with a gutsy performance to
20,
say the least.
20 points.
Thinking about the three-pointer. Now the Chargers decide against it.
The Chargers have not put this game away by any means.
A minute 40 to go. The clock becoming an ally of the Dow High Chargers. Dow High is in the bonus, so they will go to the free throw line if the Kimmicks decide to foul. And how about that? A jump ball will be called. Jessica Walker with great defense, forcing the jump ball possession to Midland. And Elaine Mahabier will call a timeout for the Midland High Chemex with 91 seconds to play in this contest.
Well, you just hope that the way the officials have been calling this game really doesn't change a lot in the last minute and 31 seconds. It would be a shame for the officials to really tighten it up and really confuse the players.
I don't think that's going to happen.
This has been a great game. I mean, it's been close from start to finish. A little bit there right before halftime, the game got kind of out of the way of heading the Dow High way, but we got a ball game.
If you're just tuning in and you want to watch this game in its entirety, air times will be Monday, February 18th through Saturday, February 23rd at 12 noon. And then Sunday, February 24th at 10 a.m. and 11 p.m. There will be future dates and times. Check the Midland Public Schools website. And also, this game will be streaming on the MPS website in the near future as well. 6-point game, 91 seconds on the clock. Each team has one timeout. The possession arrow is now in favor of the Dow High Chargers. And we have got a whistle, and they're going to have Midland inbound the ball again. The whistle was because the possession arrow had not been changed, but you just took 6 seconds off the clock because the possession arrow hasn't been changed. That is horrible.
No, they've got to add 6 seconds.
Because the possession arrow, and Elaine Mahabier is irate, and she has a right to be. There is no reason to stop play just because a possession arrow isn't changed. You can correct that if you have another jump ball. That is 6 seconds lost off the clock. That's horrible.
That's not correct. I think they have to reset it to 131.
Midland High with the basketball, and Walker loses it out of bounds. A costly turnover there for the Midland High Chemics. Emily Lyman checking back into the game for the Dow High Chargers to add some 3-point range.
And now we're seeing some full court press pressure by the Chemex.
Inbound pass, and do you foul? You do. It will send Josie Query to the free throw line for the Dow High Chargers.
Is that two on Walter or three?
I believe it's three, and it
is. Three.
So now four Midland High players with three fouls each with 68 seconds to play. That really doesn't make much of a difference.
It's not really foul trouble.
And Josie Query missing the one and one. Lily Hami with the rebound. It's only a 6-point game, 60 seconds to go. Walker with the basketball for Midland. Walker dribbling behind her back. Now she fires quickly over to Westwall, back to Walker. 3-pointer, too hard. Rebound brought down by Jenna Query. And again, the Chemex have to foul.
It looked like Holman had her hand on the ball, but I think in the nature of the moment, the officials are anticipating a foul.
This time it'll be Jenna Query that goes to the free throw line for the Dow High Chargers. Still a 1-1. Although the next Midland foul will result in the double bonus. Query struggling in the final second from the free throw line. Midland High coming back with the basketball, still only a 6-point deficit. Emily Holman trying to drive in, has the ball knocked away. Chargers defense has been phenomenal, forcing the turnovers late in this contest. Dow High working to Jenna Query, who fires back to Christine Mussel. 30 seconds to play, Chargers sensing the victory. Mussel with the ball, working to the corner to Josie Query, now back out to Maya Piper. Chargers doing a great job working the basketball around, and we've got a foul called away from the ball. Emily Holman picking up the foul. That is going to be her fifth, so Emily Holman fouls out of the game with 17 seconds to play.
Well, the official had their choice of Holman or Westfall. They both were fouling basically at the same time.
So Abby Frazier will check back into the game. It's also a double bonus for Maya Piper, who is on the free throw line for the Chargers. Piper able to get the first free throw to fall. 55-48. Chargers are 17 seconds away from picking up their 18th win of the year. Both free throws are good for Piper. Final seconds ticking down as the Midland High Chemics work the ball to Lily Hami. Three-pointer fired, count it. Hami hitting the three-pointer, but it's not going to be enough if the final seconds coming off the clock, and they're going to call a foul with 2 seconds left.
Well, I think she got pushed out of bounds. I think they kind of have to call that one.
So as a result, the Delhi Chargers will go to the free throw line. Lily Hami picking up her fourth foul.
And that was Hami's first points of the fourth quarter.
Maya Piper on the free throw line, count it. Maya Piper, who did not play the last time these two teams met, having a very good game for the Delhi Chargers coming off the bench. And she drills 4 free throws in the final 20 seconds to seal the deal for the Delhi Chargers. It is now official, the horn sounds, and the Delhi Chargers are 18-0 and are 2 games away from having an undefeated season. Just a week left to play before district, and the Delhi Chargers now 18-0 after a tremendous victory over the Midland High Chemics, who fall to 12-7 on the season. Leading scorer in the game was Jessica Walker, who finishes with 20 points for Midland. Lily Hami behind her with 19. Leading scorer for the Delhi Chargers, Josie Query, she finished with 15. Christine Muscle finishing with 12. A great team effort by the Delhi Chargers, who are now a perfect 18-0 and ranked number 5 in the state. The Delhi Chargers picking up a win here at their home court. For our entire MCTV crew and for my broadcast partner, Tom Bell, my name is Jason Harper. The final score, the Delhi Chargers 58, the Midland High Chemics 51. Good night, everyone.